Memorial Day weekend is here. Many drivers are already hitting the road for the holiday.
Jeff Flock is on the road with more.
In some ways, this is the fruits of a booming economy. Memorial Day travel. A lot of people are going to be out this year. A record number in some ways, actually the biggest number of travelers, according to AAA, since they've been tracking this in any year except 2005, pre-recession. So most of the people, of course, always travel by car. That'll be a number somewhere north of 37 million people this year. That's up 3.5% from last year. By air travel up by about 5%, and travel by rail up almost 4% this year. Good news for the folks out on the expressway, and we're, by the way, out on 294, just west of Chicago. I think we're headed for Wisconsin. Good news for us if we're in a car, and that is that gas prices, though they have been on the rise of late, have been moderating just most recently. And of course, oil took a big hit yesterday, oil prices. And so, in some ways, that's good news for travelers, because lower gas prices means you get to go farther. As we said, this is all reasonably good news, despite the snafus that it might cause for travel. That is because people have money to spend, and they're able to get out on the Memorial Day highway and get where they want to go with their families or wherever. So be careful out there. Best time to travel, by the way, any time but the late afternoon. Across the country, AAA says between 3 and 5, generally, in your area will be the worst. And, of course, there's the weather. Perhaps you see out the window right now, pelting down rain. That doesn't help either. Good luck and happy Memorial Day. I'm Jeff Flock with the Fox Business Network.